Another activity that you can utilize in e-learning is the web conferencing option. This is using another integrated module called BigBlueButton. It's designed to be very simple, just like pushing a big blue button for the instructor. To create a web conference for your courses, and this can be primarily used in hybrid and distance learning courses, as well as regular courses or web enhanced courses. To create a web conference session, you can click on Add an Activity or Resource, and then choose Big Blue Button. Then click on Add, and then we need to specify the classroom name, the virtual classroom name. So let's say week one. This module allows all the students in the course, including the instructor, to interact live with web cameras, microphones, a whiteboard, as well as live chat. The instructor also has the capability to view or to make a student a presenter and interact so that the students can lead the discussion at certain points. You can choose to open the big blue button in a new window, and then you can schedule this so it opens and closes at a specific time. Then you can choose to record it. We have to figure out the recording at this point. I've not really tested it. Then you'd click on Save and Return to the course. So at this point, we just have created the web conference, and we need to make sure that when we specify the time, we need to be online so that the students would be able to get in the conference room. At this point, the student and you as instructor, you'll click on the web conference option, and you log in automatically. Everything is integrated. Then it will ask you to allow the microphone and camera access. So you need to allow the access to it. Either right now, I'm going to click on the deny for the sake of testing here. Otherwise, it'll be too noisy with all the mic. On the left-hand side, you'll have the list of users. This is the list of all the listeners in the course. This is where the videos, the little pictures of videos of all the students will be displayed. Then in here in the middle section, this is where you, this is your whiteboard, and you can upload a presentation from this button right here. You upload the presentation. Let's say I want to upload this paper. Discuss it with the rest of the class. It can be a PowerPoint, any type of file. And then on the right hand side, this is where the class live chat will be taking place. On the top left, this is where you can share your microphone. This is how you engage the microphone for the class. The next icon to the left, you can share your own camera, and it's exactly the same view that the students will have on their side. The next icon here is to share the whole desktop. You're going to use this quite a bit. The best is to have another computer or laptop next to you, and on one computer you're broadcasting, on the other one you're seeing as to what the students are seeing on their end. There is the option here for zooming in to the document that you are presenting to the students. There's also this option for show the whiteboard, and you can use different colors here to annotate and discuss things, and you're explaining concepts to the students remotely while at the same time chatting live with them from this window. I have a different tutorial on this as well, more detailed and more in-depth, but this is the idea about this, and I'll have a link for that on the detailed e-learning guides and tutorials on the faculty resources block. So this is for live courses, live interaction. It's not necessarily used to lecture for hours. It's intended to be used for brief discussions and a brief explanation of the concept, and also bring together the class, especially if you're doing distance learning. So that's the web conferencing.